insights. This little girl caught my attention. The innocence and happiness in her face drew me towards her. Her happiness multiplied when I pointed my camera at her. To me, she seemed like the happiest person on the earth. As kids growing up, we were told to dream big. And most of the time, we were told to dream of being successful engineers and doctors. Is there anyone here who was told to dream of being happy? Good afternoon, dear Toastmasters and guests.
Good afternoon.
On March 20th, on the occasion of World Happiness Day, I got a mail. It said, join the happiness training program and learn to be happy from the experts. That mail kept me hooked onto the thought whether are we losing our happiness quotient, and happiness quotient within us is diminishing to such an extent that we are turning to become robots and we need experts to teach us how to be happy. This made me research on the happiness quotient in our country, and the results were not promising. According to United Nations report, India stands at 118th rank out of 156 countries in happiness index. It comes behind countries like Pakistan and Bangladesh. The United Nations report says, the happiness index can be used effectively to assess the progress of a nation. The report also compared the data between the onset of the recession in 2008 and after that. It is found that only Ireland and Iceland were able to maintain same levels of happiness, thanks to the high degree of social support they have. India, which is generally regarded as a country with great promise and bright future, has not doing that well. It has dipped from 111th rank in 2013 to 118th rank in 2016. Then, so it seems like our new India is shiny but unhappy. Now, coming to the various cities within our country. Our very own Garden City, Bengaluru is at 5th place. Even it is regarded as world's most dynamic city. India is the largest producer of movies in the world. So many TV channels, so many programs. Are they all failing to make us happy? Are we losing our contentment? Are we going far from our inner peace? You may think of many reasons. Individually, the reasons could be you're not yet where you want to be in your career, or you have experienced financial setbacks, or your children aren't doing up to your expectations, or your neighbors aren't friendly enough, or your boss doesn't appreciate your efforts. And the list goes on. And let me suggest you, these are not at all the reasons. These are the excuses you give yourself for not to be happy. As our mythology points out, in Satyaruga, the fight was between two worlds, that is Devaloka and Asuraloka. In Treta Yuga, the fight was between Rama and Ravana. They were rulers from two different countries. In Dwapara Yuga, the fight was between Kauravas and Pandavas. They were part of the same family. Now, do you observe a pattern here? The fight is between good and the evil. Now, where do you think the evil is in Kali Yuga? The evil is within us. The good and the evil is within us. Which will emerge victorious has got to do a lot with your happiness index. Our neighboring country, Bhutan, can teach us a lot about being happy. It's been one of the happiest countries in the world for a long time now. Let me share you an interesting fact about Bhutan. They planted around 1,08,000 trees on the honor of birth of Bhutan's prince. At any such event, at any other place, would lead to extravagant celebrations. They prefer to live a life that is closer to their roots, less materialistic, yet more fulfilling, rather than participating in a rat race, which leads to the vicious cycle of greed and disregard to environment and people. Researchers have determined that happy people have better immune systems. They tend to endure pain better than unhappy people, so they live longer. And they get greater opportunities to enjoy life and everything within it. Now, look at this picture again. We all have this kind of innocence and happiness within us. Like the outfits you choose every day, which makes you look good, and the dishes you choose to have, which satisfies your taste buds. We all have the choice at every moment of the day, so to be happy or not. Friends, if we try to explore that happier self within us, we will be able to build a happier self, a happier locality, and a happier nation. Like Ralph Malston says, happiness is a choice and not a result. Nothing can make you happy until you decide to be happy. Nobody can make you happy unless you choose to be happy. Happiness will not come to you. Happiness can only come from you. Audio resources.